We tried to meet as many ordinary people, Kashmiri people, as possible of diverse communities in different parts of Kashmir. So that included urban Srinagar as well as various parts of rural Kashmir. And we were probably the first team to do this because most journalists had not ventured out of Srinagar or even out of a small enclave in Srinagar till we did so. And what we found there was that people were wanting to protest. They were very upset, but they could not protest because peaceful protest is not allowed, A. And also the fact that in many of the households in rural Kashmir, young children had been picked up by the police completely illegally. So they were being illegally detained in police stations or army camps. And so the parents would be so fearful for the safety of their children that they would not be able to voice any protest. And this is what we found there. We also spoke to a lot of Kashmiri women and girls who were especially angry that the Indian Prime Minister and the Indian government was talking about liberating Kashmiri women. And they were upset because the leaders of the ruling party in India were talking about Kashmiri girls as though they are the spoils of war and saying, oh, Indian men can now get fair Kashmiri brides and things like that. So there was a lot of anger and a lot of sense that Kashmiri people didn't count, that Kashmir has been reduced to territory, which is being treated by the Indian government as though it is a Muslim territory to be conquered by a Hindu majoritarian government.
7 million people have been confined to their homes without any communication for more than 2 weeks in disputed Kashmir. This is Ishrat, a Kashmiri woman from Srinagar.
For 12 days, we have been locked inside our houses. We cannot go out of our homes. We cannot go and get medicines. We have small children, and we can't even go and buy toffees for them. There is nothing for us. We have relatives outside, brothers and sisters in countries outside, but we have no contact or news of them. We have absolutely no information about their well-being.
I wanted to ask you about Indian Prime Minister Modi saying Kashmir's previous status was unjust for Kashmiri women because they lost their inheritance rights if marrying a person outside the region. Your response to Modi implying he was doing this for the women of Kashmir?
Yeah, so that's the Kashmiri women had the best response to this. They said that, look, we're fighting patriarchy here, but so are you, aren't you? Women are fighting patriarchy in their own cultures and societies all over the world. But who are our oppressors to be claiming to liberate us? And it's especially galling to hear these words from Modi when his party men are actually saying things like, oh, now that, you know, now our Indian men can get fair Kashmiri brides. And so Kashmiri girls and women would tell us, you know, we are being talked about as though we are the spoils of war, as though we are apples and peaches of Kashmir for somebody to just steal. So this is rape culture language coming from the ruling party in India towards Kashmiri girls and women.